Hey all, in this video I'm going to show you how to set construction properties and change internal loads of your building. In the previous video we have set building geometry that defines our zone, and we have set some windows and they connect to this building component. This one is actually double clickable, so if you double click on that, a form will pop up. We can enter a number of different parameters. In the first tab, the SIA tab, so that's the Swiss Engineering and Architects Association, that's what SER stands for. In this tab, in the bottom, you have a summary of certain geometric properties, so it would say how much floor area you have, what's your wall area, what's your roof area, and what's your windows area. And here you can change the schedule, the building type according to SER 2024. Now, if you change, if you click here on this, oh, actually it's all in German. Just notice, but yeah, I guess that's, you can translate that easily should you not speak German. So in the building use type, you can change the general category of the building, and I think in the exercise 2 you're going to look at offices, which is Büro. Then you can change the room type. So again, this is all according to SER 2024. For details, have a look at the norm, which I think we can also provide to you, or you already have, I guess. Yeah, so the room type, I guess for the exercise, we have a Großraumbüro, like a large office, open space office. But yeah, you can change that if you want. And the building quality, again, according to SER 2024, would change, obviously the quality of the building. And Bestand means existing building, and that usually has very bad construction properties. Standardwert is the standard, which you have to fulfill. And Zielwert target value would be very good construction. Now, if you change these things, actually, if you change any of these properties, it's indicated here. Changing these things will also impact the envelope, internal gains, and ventilation parameters in these tabs. So now let's say we have a standard building, and now we can go to this tab, which stands for envelope, and here you would find wall properties, floor properties, window properties, and roof properties. And right now there's no database connected to this because these numbers are based on the database of the SER 2024. Now if we change, for example, this to Bestand, let's just remember this value, wall U value 0.2. If we change this to existing building, then yeah, you can see that the database for this has another value. You can also overwrite these values if you like. Then currently all opaque surfaces are treated the same. So if you change one U value for wall, it would also change it for floor and for roof. Yeah, we also have emissions values for embodied emissions of these constructions per square meter, and also cost parameters per square meter. The windows have a couple of more parameters, and some of those you will actually have to work with in the exercise. So you would find G value here, the G value to total, and that's the one when the sunscreen is activated at this certain set point. So this shading set point you can also activate. And what it means is if on this window, you have a surface, a solar irradiation over 500 watts per square meter, then, that's too high, but let's say 200, then instead of having this G value, 0.65 of the original window, the sunscreen is activated and the total G value turns to 0.2 in this case. And again, this is also according to SER 2024. In this tab, you have internal gains. Again, according to SER 2024, Yeah, you can, if you are interested, you can have a look how these parameters change your results. But I think that's not part of the exercise. And ventilation properties. Once you're done with the edits, you can simply close it here, wait a couple of seconds, and then that should be updated. Yeah, let's change one more thing again to see to show you how that changes your demands. Yeah, let's change from existing building to target, to a really good construction. So here you see all the properties being really good now. And yes, your heating demand significantly decreased. The electricity loads stayed the same because those are actually just defined by the internal gains, by the equipment heat and the lighting loads. Okay, and so much for this video.